What's going on? I'm Leezy the Gifted, and I'm here today to talk to you about why you are made for more.
I was made for more. Pivot the way that it's done, what you're playing, boy. I can't wait no more. Haters cannot hold me back, I'ma break the door.
So the reason that I got into music originally was because I wanted to outlet my emotions, but my goals started with wanting to be wealthy, wanting to be rich, wanting to be popping, wanting to have all the chains and the bottles and the life and all of that stuff. My motivation has really been dictated by that. And I've been motivated a lot with the goals, with the end goal of achievement, with achieving those goals of being this multi-platinum artist, going on stage, touring, being famous, rich, all of those things. And along my journey, you know, a lot of people had made me realize that I was made for more than just the average lifestyle. You know, the first story I want to tell is about my teacher, Miss Wendy Reeves Hampton, who teaches at Los Lomas High School. She was my 10th grade English teacher, one of the coolest people I've ever met. When I graduated from high school, I went back to Los Lomas. I wanted to go visit, and I had hard copies of my second ever mixtape, and I wanted to hand one to her in person because she was such a big supporter. I met her in the parking lot. I said, "Here, Miss Reeves Hampton, here's your copy of my CD. Thanks so much for supporting." And she asked me, "Lee, what are you doing nowadays? What's your plan?" And I was like, "Oh, I want to be a sports agent. That's what I wanted to be. I want to be a sports agent, so I'm going to college. I'm probably gonna do sports marketing, and then, you know, music's the plan B." How crazy is that? And Miss Reeves Hampton looked at me crazy, and she's like, "What? No, music is the plan A, and there is no plan B." When she told me that, she told me what I wanted to hear. I felt that in my heart, but I didn't want to admit it to people. And when she told me that, guys, I never looked back. Never did I look back. And Miss Reeves Hampton, I hope you're watching this. I really, really appreciate all the support, because that statement right there, I've never looked back from that. The second story I wanna tell you, my friend Evan Maeda, who was the founder of Gifted by Choice, he wanted me to make him a mixtape of songs that would go really well into his car, because he didn't have any way to play music. So I slipped one of my songs, one of my earliest ever songs that I never really released, let him listen to it, and he was like, "Hey, this song's really good. Is this you?" I said, "Yes." He said, "This is a really dope song, man. You should start taking music a little bit more seriously. You should put a mixtape together." And again, never did I look back. And that was the first person to ever tell me, "Hey, you should actually do music seriously." Miss Reeves Hampton, that was actually the second story. The third happened way later in my career, when I was at Chico State University. In Chico, Halloween is one of the biggest weekends, or one of the biggest, let's say, holidays in Chico. I was in Chico, and I was part of a Jewish fraternity called AE Pi. And I wanted to put on a party. I wanted to do something that was groundbreaking, that was super crazy, but I wanted to make an opportunity for myself to perform live. Shout out to my boy Tone. He's the one who actually gave me the idea. What we did was we used the house where a couple of our Jewish fraternity brothers lived. It was on West Sacramento Street. For those of you who live in Chico, you know where that is. But if you don't, all of the parties happen on 1st Street, 2nd Street, 3rd Street, the numbered streets. But West Sacramento is by the Avs, which is way, it's kind of like way out there. It's away. The reason I'm telling you that is because all the numbered streets where all the Halloween parties happen, that's where all the police are circling and they're stopping the parties. Again, why did we choose Halloween? Because that's when all the out-of-towners come to Chico. So I said, "Let's put on a party." Put on a party. My Jewish fraternity brothers worked as security, and they worked the door. We actually had to promote this whole thing ourselves, and we actually created a stage. I used my own money. Me and a couple of the bros went to Lowe's and bought a bunch of cinder blocks and plywood. We got 2 2x4s, big pieces of wood. The day before, we went and threw the cinder blocks down on the ground. It took us about 2 hours. We threw the cinder blocks down on the ground, threw the plywood on top of it. We built a stage, and I got a DJ. Shout out to my boy Chris, DJ Chris. He put his DJ table on there, kind of off to the side. He had a microphone. I got the mic. So the night of the party ended up being a huge success. And basically the rules were, if you were from out of town, like if you showed your ID and it wasn't a Chico State ID, you had to pay $5 to get in. Nobody under 18 is allowed. That was basically how it went. We ended up grossing, I think, $400 or $500. It ended up working out super well. It was lit. We did not get shut down. We ended the party at 1:30. No police, nobody got hurt. No fights happened. It ended up being a super successful night, and everyone loved the performance. The reason I'm telling you this story is because that story made me realize that I could do a lot more than just music. I could put events on, I could rally the troops and get people together. The last story I wanna tell you actually really happened in my video last week, where I went to speak to the Contra Costa School of Performing Arts. If you haven't watched that video, you should definitely go check it out. It's on my YouTube channel. I think I'm gonna put it in the description below. Go check out that video. But doing that, where I spoke to two groups of middle school classes, really made me realize that music is not about the money. It's not. I mean, it's not about the riches and the fame and the platinum plaques and the dope house and the chains and the cars. It's not about that stuff. Although, yes, I want to get all of those things. It's about, I realize that we are made for more than just ourselves. We're made for more than just ourselves. We're made for others. We are made to try and help the world. And that's honestly what I want to do with my music, with this YouTube channel, with our clothing brand, Gifted by Choice. I want to inspire you to go and help other people with whatever it is they want to do. And I want to help you accomplish what you want to do. Guys, the moral of the story is we are all made for more than just ourselves. We're made for more than the average lifestyle. We're made for more than just going to school, getting a degree, getting the 9-to-5, putting your money in the 401k, sitting around and waiting till you're 65 to collect your 401k check. At which point, by the way, the 401k, you're probably gonna end up outliving the money you put in your 401k. So I just feel like we are made for so much more. We're made for more. I just hope that everybody can take that and go and do something with their lives. I want you to go out and do more than whatever it is you're doing today. Don't be average, all right? Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell notification, and big announcement, we got hoodies, brand new Gifted by Choice hoodies. All you gotta do is click below or go to giftedbychoice.com and you can purchase yours. We only ordered a very limited amount. Like at this point, we've already started selling a few undercover. I don't even know how many we have left. It's not that many, guys. So if you want your Gifted by Choice by hoodie, then you need to get yours quick. Giftedbychoice.com. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next week. Peace. I was made for more. Pivot the way that it's done with you playing, boy. I can't wait no more. Haters cannot hold me.